nothing like a hot shower to get the old heart started.
Especially after a good night's sleep in a well-aired bed, eh, son?
What the hell's going on?
Three guesses, sweetheart. You touch me and I'll scream this place down.
You try it and you'll have real problems.
Besides, we've got a little treat for you. Cast the pillow. What do you think you're doing, you stupid cows?
You shouldn't have touched the pianola. It was mean and childish.
Mr. Dobson was a good friend to us.
Yeah, and you could have hurt him real bad kicking his pills away like that, Reb.
And here's a little extra for you for bringing Bobby's Walkman. You nasty little bitch.
I think you're real smart, don't you? Not one of you got the guts to take me on alone.
Oh, really? Well, this isn't a fight. It's a lesson.
Only some of us learn slower than others.
Bitch. Whew. Now, Reb, it only goes to serve you right.
Right. Coast clear.
Get you, Bryant.
Really?
Well, I'll tell you something. You say one word to anybody, it'll be the last word you speak.
And at least the reporters have gone. The department should have the papers processed later this morning, and then Wells will be released.
Well, what about Maguire?
It's still under consideration, Meg, but I'm expecting a phone call this morning. Hmm.
Now, what's next? Oh.
Yes, the gardening program.
Oh, of course, I don't know if I've made everything clear, Miss. I won't be here much longer. I would just like to get the women started.
I think it's an excellent idea. I wouldn't mind a bit of gardening myself.
It's extra work supervising those women. Oh, come on, we've got enough to do.
Well, Stan will be doing all the work.
And he has to be accompanied.
Oh, I'm sure we can manage it only be an hour or two extra a day.
I just said that we're already overloaded with work commitments. And, Stanley, I'm sorry, but this competition of yours...
Competition? Oh.
Well, I had intended speaking to you about it, Mrs. Reynolds, before the meeting, but as everybody seems to know...
Well, for what it's worth, I reckon it's an excellent idea.
Well, it's certainly different, and I can imagine how the women would feel about it. Just the same, I think we have to give it a lot of thought.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, I'd expect that.
Oh, it doesn't take a lot of thought to realise the security risks we'd be taking.
Sometimes the end justifies the means, Colleen. There's an element of risk in everything.
And it would do wonders for morale.
All right, then, why don't you just hand them the keys of the prison and let them come and go as they please?
Oh, they're just being facetious.
Yes, all right. But I am against it. However, if it is okay, then we're going to have to be damn careful about who we allow to go. And I won't back down on that.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm glad to have everyone's opinion. But in the long run, it will be my decision. All right, Stanley?
Yes, yes, of course.
I think that's all. Thank you all for your time. Back to work.
What's the matter, Colleen? I know you've got problems.
Oh, just leave it, will you, Meg? Anyhow, you won't have to worry much longer. I am looking for a new job, and as soon as I find one, you and Anne can have this whole place to yourselves.
She's late for breakfast, King.
Yeah, but doesn't her hair look nice and clean?
We could have saved you some toast, but we ran out of honey.
And K-pop.
You got a phone call from your Uncle Kevin. I'm going to call him back later.
Great. Thanks, Mr. May.
Well, no news is good news, eh? You're lucky you didn't get carted off to Barnhurst.
Well, even if I had, I'm glad I spent some time here. You're quite special, you know that?
Oh, I wish the judge thought so.
I better get me stuff together. See you around.
Yeah, expect some.
Stevens. I thought you might like to know you were right about Eddie.
You seem surprised.
Still too many questions no one wants to answer.
Well, I've told you all I know, Mr. Manning.
But come on, Stevens. Someone told you. Now I want to know who that was.
You just missed her.
King. She gets out today.
That's right.
They're not at all keen, Stan. They feel it would put an awful strain on security.
You tell them how much it would mean to the women.
Yes. Look, don't say anything to them just yet. Who knows, maybe the department will change its mind.
Well, thanks anyway, Mrs. Reynolds.
Poor man, it
That's hard enough for him having to retire.
I know, and I will try again. But I'm not too happy about Colleen's attitude. Do you think there's any chance of repercussions amongst the officers if this thing did go ahead?
You mean a strike?
Yes, I don't want to buy into industrial action.
Well, I'd say you'd have more problems if Camilla Wells thought we were scared of such a trip.
You're probably right. Prison officers fear Wentworth's singing angels. Oh, we'll just have to wait and see.
Myra Desmond's outside. She's just been inducted. Do you want to see her?
Okay. Poor Myra. I'm dreading this.
Know how you feel. Thanks, Mrs. Wood. Come on, Myra.
I can't tell you how sorry I am.
Look at me on the outside, telling people how to run their own lives, and look what I did to my own two kids.
Myra, if there's anything I can do,
Yeah, Meg, thanks. Kay and Alan, if you wouldn't mind keeping an eye on them, it's hitting pretty hard. They're going to need someone.
Yes, of course.
And I'm here if you need anything.
Thanks. Can't turn the clock back, though. It's all I really need.
Well, that should keep you going.
Oh, jeez, I'm sorry. I don't know how that happened.
Oh, dear, it's not your day at all, son.
Yeah, you should have stayed in bed, kid.
All right, you play your stupid games, though. I think a four-year-old would do a lot better.
Well, to be sure, and isn't she laughing at it? It reminds me of my Auntie Pat had triplets. And my Uncle Kevin went gunning for the fathers of the other two.
Just what'll I get out of my Uncle Kevin anymore? Just a few blows.
You got something going.
Forget it.
Ladies, you can stop work for a minute. I have some news for you.
I'm not sure I want to hear it. The news around here is all bad.
Oh, I think you want to hear this, don't you, Mrs. Morris?
Yes, I certainly do. McGuire, you and Wells are both being released.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Really? Do you want to tell us who pulled what strings, Mrs. Morris?
There's nothing undercover about it, Smart. The department simply reviewed the case and reversed the VJ's decision. Now, that's
all. Well, what do you know? There is some justice in the world after all. Well,
I'll give you 5 minutes to say goodbye, and then I'll take you to collect your things.
Thank you, Mrs. Morris. Did I make a phone call? Mr. Manning said a big one.
All right, come this way.
Well, you certainly are a sly old fox, Camilla. How did you manage that?
Oh, I don't think it had anything to do with me. I think the department has got cold feet. Well, I think I'm going to miss you, Judy. You taught me a lot in a short time.
Hey, come on. You don't need anyone to teach you anything. You're a very cluey lady.
Well, everyone, I hope you're going to watch the news tonight. And if my editor's really on the ball, I'll make the afternoon papers.
But you wouldn't want to tell too many people about Mo.
Oh, come on. If you think I'm going to walk out of here and forget all about you, you're wrong. Anyway, Mo will be there to remind me.
Oh, look, I know what you said about the job, but if you change
your
mind...
Don't turn me down. I'm counting on you to pull Larry and Curly into shape.
Two fellas? Lucky you.
Cats, darling, cats.
Cats?
Pedigree Persian to love them.
Well, everybody needs somebody.
Well, Wentworth taught me that.
Last in line.
Yeah, well, I need you to do something for me.
Me?
I thought you and Sonny had a few deals going.
Yeah, well, Sonny can't help me with this one. I've got to get into the singing group.
You've got to be kidding. Dobson will never let you in.
Wait till you see the act I'm going to buck. You'd have to have a heart of stone to knock me back. I want you to get the women around.
Hey, well, why me? What's in it for me?
What do you mean?
Well, I wasn't born yesterday, Rip. If you're so anxious to go on that trip, there's only one reason, and it's got nothing to do with singing.
Meaning?
Meaning I want in. Forget it.
Okay, but you're going nowhere without me.
Guess I haven't much choice, have I?
That's right.
Gee, didn't expect to see you here.
Can we talk?
What about?
Come on, King. You told Sonia Stevens that Eddie was on the take. Now I want to know the whole story.
But Mr. Manning, I've got a friend in there. That's half my rent money. Just give me half an hour to get rid of this joke and we'll talk, okay?
Half an hour.
You sounded like a veritable barnyard.
Oh, thanks for
Well, what do you think, Mr. Dodgson?